We all understand the twinge of discomfort at the thought that we share a common ancestor with the apes. No one can embarrass you like a relative. Our closest ones, the chimpanzees, frequently behave inappropriately in public. There's an understandable human need to distance ourselves from them. A central premise of traditional belief is that we were created separately from all the other animals. It's easy to see why this idea has taken hold. It makes us feel special. But what about our kinship with the trees? How does that make you feel? Okay, here's a segment of the oak tree's DNA. Think of it like a barcode. The instructions written in the code of life tell the tree how to metabolize sugar. Now let's compare it with the same section of my own DNA. The DNA doesn't lie. This tree and me, we're long-lost cousins. And it's not just the trees. If you go back far enough, you'll find that we share a common ancestor with the butterfly, gray wolf, mushroom, shark, bacterium, sparrow. What a family. Other parts of the barcode vary from species to species. That's what makes the difference between an owl and an octopus. Unless you have an identical twin, there's no one else in the universe with the exact same DNA as you. Within other species, the genetic differences provide the raw material for natural selection. The environment selects which genes survive and multiply. When it comes to the genetic instructions for life's most basic functions, say digesting sugars, we and other species are almost identical. That's because those functions are so basic to life, they evolved before the various life forms branched off from each other. This is our tree of life. Science has made it possible for us to construct this family tree for all the species of life on Earth.